is an easy tutorial video for college students on how to navigate the BLAST website. Visit Google and type in BLAST. Click on the first link. Click on Nucleotide BLAST. In the search bar, enter the primer sequence. Be sure to eliminate all non-nucleotide characters. Under Choose Search Set, select Nucleotide Collection. Under Program Selection, click BLAST N for somewhat similar sequences. Then click BLAST. The results are displayed in three ways. The first is a graphical overview, showing how other sequences match with your original sequence. Second is a list of significant alignments with accession information. Take notice of the E value. And last is a detailed view of each query sequence aligned to the sequence you searched. Take notice of the forward and reverse primer, the E value is the number of hits that expected to occur by chance. The closer to zero the E value is, the better. Now calculate the amplified sequence. This is the difference between the highest and lowest nucleotide positions. Make sure to add 1, since each fragment length includes both ends.
Click on the accession link of the hit containing the human taster allele with the lowest E value. Notice that you'll find its base pair length, its accession, the source, as well as the references. Go to the middle of the page, which contains information about the gene and its mRNA. At the bottom of the page, copy the coding sequence and paste into a separate Word document. Delete any of the non-bases to get only the amplified product. Go back to the page and select the accession link for the human non-taster allele. Make sure to copy and paste the base pairs only. For your purpose, make sure to put in whatever species you need to define. For example, Pan troglodytes, Pan paniscus, and gorilla. Make sure to only use the complete coding sequence.
For each organism, you are repeating the same process. Part 3 coming up right now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Click on Home at the top and then NCBI on the bottom right hand side of the page. Under Featured at the bottom of the page, click on Map Viewer. Find Homo sapiens and click on the B button on the other side of the page. Enter the primer sequence. Select BLAST END, which is somewhat similar sequences, and then click on BLAST. Find and click on Human Genome, and then the marked number 7 chromosome. Click Click on the blue arrow next to Gene Sequences. On the left-hand side of the page, click right above 7Q35. Zoom in 2 times to locate TAS2R38 gene on the chromosome. The magnified portion is the part of the chromosome where the gene is located. To zoom in further, follow the line from the gene and click. Scroll up and down to locate any neighboring genes that are next to the TAS2R38 gene, and you may zoom in as many times as needed to get a closer view. On the right-hand side, it will give you a description of what each gene codes for. Once you find the genes next to TAS2R38, that also code for a taste receptor, you may stop.
Now for the last part on bioservice.org. Go to bioservice.org by typing it into the address bar. Click the Enter button under Sequence Server on the left-hand side. Click Create Sequence. Make the first sequence by typing taster in the name box, then go to the document where you've saved your sequences. Copy and paste the entire sequence for taster into the sequence box. Remember, bases only. Click OK and the sequence will be created. Clear the fields, put non-taster in the name box and the corresponding sequence in the sequence box. Once again, click OK to create the sequence. Repeat these steps for pan troglodyte, pan peniscus, gorilla, the forward primer, and the amplicon. Once you've finished all 7 sequences, you can begin comparing. Select the boxes next to taster, non-taster, and the amplicon, and then click on compare. The yellow highlights indicate mismatches between sequences or regions where a sequence is absent. Notice where the amplicon begins and where it ends. Also notice the yellow highlight at nucleotide position 145. Exit out of the window and unselect Amplicon. Enter 1100 into the Nucleotides per Page field and click Redraw to display the entire gene. Record any SNPs and their possible effects on codons. Do this by counting in triplets from the start codon, ATG, and using an amino acid code chart to investigate whether an amino acid is changed by an SNP or not. Exit out of the window. Select pan troglodytes, pan peniscus, and gorilla to compare them. Look at nucleotide positions 145, 785, and 886. Notice which one is the outlier in each case and what this means in regards to the ancestry of this gene at each SNP. Exit out of the window. Uncheck pan troglodytes, pan peniscus, and gorilla. Check the forward primer and compare. Record where the primer binds. Also notice the SNP of the primer and reflect on why this is important to the experiment.